This is what I wanted to talk to you about. This has to come down because it's too close to the house anyway. And I had a thought, okay?
Okay.
We have to have a column between the kitchen and the den.
You want to go all Middle Earth?
What if we went totally Middle Earth and we cut the tree down and we had it dried, like with the bark on it and everything?
Uh-huh.
And we used it for the column between the rooms. It might take too long to have it dried, but...
I don't know. I'd have to do some research.
Woo! This is awesome.
Josh, Jim, and I are driving 3 hours north to Tupelo, Mississippi to see my buddy Chad at Superior Artisan Wood and Slab. We're gonna see what we can do with this parasol tree. So I was trying to explain to them what your dry kiln is.
Trying to explain.
You got pretty
close.
But
it's a vacuum.
Your water will boil at a much lower temperature under that pressure than, say, it would at your stovetop, right? So that's how we can dry really quickly with a little less degrade.
So let me explain. These homeowners, they're from the Pacific Northwest, and they are obsessed with Hobbit furniture. Okay, so what we're wanting to do here, I'm wanting to get this dried and use this tree somewhere in the design. At first I was thinking as a post, but I don't think it's strong enough. What do you think, Chad?
I'm not certain about strength given the application.
If we had cut this out of, say, a maple tree, mm-hmm. or oak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, something this fast growing and the strength of it is not, I don't think it's construction grade.
Mm-hmm.
Might would hold up a hobbit house, though.
Might would hold up a hobbit house.
But not a human one.
But not a human one. We can dry it and use it in another application, if you'd like to do that. I think I've got some other material that may suit you better structurally.
Okay. He's got these cool hand-hewn logs. You know, they're 150 years old, been holding up a house for 150 years. If they'll hold up a house for that long, that's a good sign.
I'm gonna cheerlead here.
This is tough. I'm putting the one hand on it.
Push it in there, fellas.
All right. So how long?
So the fresh piece, the Chinese parasol tree, 4 weeks.
Okay. What up?
Hey, how much, Ben? How are you this morning?
I'm looking at what you got behind you there. What is that? I mean, is it all redwood?
That is all redwood.
Shut up. Michael Johnson owns OG Redwood. They go into private properties and mill up redwood trees that have fallen naturally. So what I'm wanting to do is build some sort of table with, you know, some West Coast redwood, a live edge slab. So like, how old are these trees?
These trees are about 600 to 2,000 years old.
Gosh, it's a super limited resource, but it's kind of a bucket list thing for me as a woodworker is to build a big live edge redwood table. Or send me some pictures of some slabs you think would work. And once we pick a piece, what does it take, like a week, you think, to ship it?
Within a week, week and a half.
Thanks, Mike.
I will seriously drop this.
Like, we need, like, music playing before we open this up.
What will we play?
Like, choir, orchestra. This is like Christmas morning, okay? You wake up Christmas morning, you run downstairs, they're like your birthday, like, you're so excited, you wanna know what this big gift is. And it's this one package that we get to unwrap.
Ooh, man, that's pretty.
Dude.
This thing is gonna be gorgeous.
I'm not building a big table here. We're building an entryway table. But, I mean, how cool is it to work with somebody who's moving here from the coast, the West Coast, where these redwoods grow?
It's burnt. Yes.
So this tree, these were cut pre-World War II, and then there was a forest fire in like 1964, and it charred the exterior of it, and it preserved mm-hmm. the tree.
Awesome.
You wanna run it through the sander?
Kinda.
Let's do it. Do one more. We're gonna do one more. We're wanting to do live edge because it, you know, it goes back to that hobbit style. So we're gonna run it through the sander. We're gonna then hand sand it and take it all the way down to 800 grit. And then we're gonna seal it. And we're gonna just let the natural figure of this wood tell the story. Since we couldn't use the tree, the log that we carried up to Tupelo and got dried.
Yeah.
What if we took it and cut it and made that the base?
Yeah.
Just have two legs, real simple.
That's gonna look real, real nice, Mr. Ben.
Greg, I would get up and help you, but this chair is just so dang comfortable.
It's okay. It's okay.
When I first got into woodworking several years ago, I had people tell me, like, you need to check out Greg Harkins. Well, you know, who is that? Well, he makes rocking chairs. He's made rocking chairs for all of the presidents since Jimmy Carter. So why is this chair, why does it have a short arm?
Well, it's a guitar playing chair.
Oh, so it can fit.
Mm-hmm. Sold literally hundreds of those.
Greg builds these twig furniture chairs. Nobody else in Mississippi builds furniture like that. So this is the perfect situation to bring him in. This is the style of bench that we're building with the natural found materials. Do you just go out and find these pieces?
Just walk and look.
And you know what to look for.
I like them to have this nice little curve.
Flares out.
It flares out, just gives it a little more character.
Good stuff. All right, let's put it together. The furniture that I build is, you know, I might build with some reclaimed wood, but it's usually from, you know, wood that's had time to dry and it's cured and it's pretty straight. But Greg's just out here like, taking firewood and building furniture out of it. How long have these been soaking?
Probably 3 hours. They probably should have been soaked overnight. But we tough old boys.
Tougher than hickory bark.
That's right. We're gonna go this way first, and this way second.
There's an art to this.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a science. Feeling and figuring it out the whole way. No clamps, no measuring.
You can use hickory, you can use elm, and elm is actually supposed to be the better of the two, but I like the hickory much better.
I mean, it's so cool. This is such a, I love learning a new skill from someone who is a master at it, and he is definitely a master at this. Ready? On the count of three, you look up, okay? 1, 2, 3. Welcome to the Fukuda house.
Oh my gosh. I love the color.
Yeah?
I do.
Good.
I love the color.
Good.
Oh my goodness. This is me. This is me.
Yeah, perfect.
This
is me. Whoa, that's all that. I ever wanted
this
anyone
is
to say.
Me.
How
Absolutely.
About these leaves?
You yes, have the yes, best yes. trees.
And the bench?
You like the bench?
I love the bench.
Beautiful.
Okay. That's Hobbity.
That is Hobbity, yes!
There's so many Hobbity things coming.
Okay, so a buddy of mine, Greg Harkins, he's a very famous Mississippi woodworker, and he and I built this together.
Awesome! Wow. It is beautiful.
Isn't that cool?
Very nice.
And then copper. You love copper, so we gave you copper lanterns, and there's more where that came from. You'll
oh,
see.
Yay! It couldn't be better. Well, if we were inside, it would.
You want to see?
I do want to see.
Okay, go in. It's your house.
I'm still not over you moving from Hawaii and the Northwest and...
To be here.
To be here.
I think you're going to find your friends and you're going to love it here, especially once you move in. This house is amazing.
Ooh, these are pretty doors. My goodness.
Wow.
Wow. How beautiful. Look
wow.
at the mantle.
How long Isn't have y'all that... had that in storage?
Oh, a long time. But this is where it needed to be. This yeah. is perfect.
Look to your right, behind the plant. You
oh,
said you needed a walking
look
stick.
Look at that. This is perfect.
Mr. Greg gave those to you guys
oh,
as a gift.
Oh, that's so nice. Yeah. And that's special.
So,
wow.
This is
oh,
something
look.
That I built. I don't do a lot of live edge furniture. I don't do any Hobbit furniture. So this is my attempt.
That's gorgeous.
You
it
like
really
it?
Is gorgeous. Oh,
absolutely beautiful.
Okay, this is actually a slab of redwood from the West Coast, where you guys come from. And the legs here, these posts, are actually the Chinese parasol tree that was in your front
that's
yard.
Cool.
So, a little bit of your old home on the West Coast, a little bit of your new home.
And it was
right
meant,
here.
This tree was meant to be the column in your living room.
It's perfect.
We thought it would be a fun Hobbity touch.
It is a fun Hobbity touch.
Yeah.
And of course, there's your watercolor of your house. So you
we
have...
get ours in the beginning.
Yeah.